So today we shall be discussing about the measures of dispersion. So previously we have studied this measures of central tendency. What were those? They were mean, median and mode. And today we will discuss about these measures of dispersion. So the first question here is, so previously we have studied about the measures of central tendency. In this class, we will be studying about the measures of dispersion. So, the first question that arises is, for a given set of data, we have talked about this data from the very starting of this course. So, we say the presence of central tendencies, they have their advantages, that we can talk about the averages on or mean, or we can talk about the medians, or we can talk about the mode for the corresponding data. So what we have done, we have represented in central tendency the all of the data through this quantity mean, median or mode. So they are saying the presence of central tendencies has their advantages. We obtain a sensible information about the data. Then what is the need to study this measures of dispersion? First thing. So, the answer to this lies in the fact that all the central tendencies, either it is mean or median or mode, they give us a single number from which we can estimate, okay, this is the average for my given data and this is the median and this is the mode. That represents the complete set of data. But they are saying this average that cannot completely define the data. So, for that, moreover, there are a number of series whose average may be the same, but still there could be wide differences in those series. And third thing is that to study how much there is a variability of the data, how much is the data that is spread out in the space. So that variability is measured by this dispersion of observations. So here, measures of dispersion that is required because we wanted to study the extent to which the items, they vary from one another, first thing. Moreover, how much they vary from the central value, say mean, median or mode. So that is the main thing that is required. So what is the meaning of dispersion here? Dispersion, it refers to variations of the items among themselves. So how much one particular item varies from the other item, that is the first thing. Second thing, how much is the variation of such items about average? This is the second thing. So here we will study about the scatteredness or the spreadness of the individual items that are given in this series. So the objectives that are fulfilled by this dispersion that are, first is to determine how reliable is an average. Firstly, we are given some data and we have calculated its mean. We have also calculated median. So now we'll study how much reliable is this. By reliability we mean how much closeness is there from the mean or the corresponding median of all the data values. So we say if the dispersion is large, that means the scatter is much large. So that means if the average is somewhere here and we have data which is spread out largely, so that is so the difference of this particular point and this particular point, the average would be large. So that means if dispersion is large, the average would not stand out and will be unreliable. Moreover, if the dispersion is small, suppose this is the mean and your data is somewhat like this. So here the scatteredness of data is less. So that means dispersion is less. So the distance between any two quantities here would be small. So we say average represents the individual data very closely. So we can say average is a good estimate for all the data. So this is first point. Second objective that it covers is that to compare the variability of two or more series. So suppose we have one data with us and we have another series having another kind of data with us. So now to compare these two series among themselves. So that is also done to using this dispersion. So whenever you have high degree of variation, that means the series, they are quite different from each other and could not be compared as such. So third objective is for facilitating the use of other measures of statistics. Now here for we will study later on about correlation and regression and testing of hypothesis. All these utilizes this methods of dispersion. That means they'll either use this स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन और दे विल यूटिलाइज दिस मीन मीडियन मोड. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दीज वील से दैट आर ऑल्सो दीज मेजर्स ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स आर ऑल्सो यूजफुल वेन एवर वी वॉन्टेड टू मेक अ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ डिसीजन आउट ऑफ इट. नेक्स्ट इज इट दे फॉर्म्स द बेसिस फॉर स्टैटिस्टिकल क्वालिटी कंट्रोल. नाउ वॉट डज दिस मीन स्टैटिस्टिकल क्वालिटी कंट्रोल? इट मीन्स दैट इट विल टेल यू द एक्सटेंट ऑफ डिस्पर्जन. That means that would determine whether kind of product that is being produced in particular factory, would that contain random errors? For example, you say the extent of dispersion, that gives you the indication as to the management as to whether the variation in the quality of product is either due to random errors or there is some effect that is present over here. So that is what we wanted to see, right? So next is, when can we call? So now suppose I gave some new definition. Okay, now say this quantity, I'm saying I'm defining my own measure of dispersion. So now when can I call this to be a good measure of dispersion? Whatever quantity that I have created. So first of all, it should be easy to understand. It should be simple to calculate. It should be uniquely defined. That means it should not produce two or more answers. It should base upon all the observations. Should not be affected by extreme values. Extreme values is, that means, for example, this is the mean and the extreme values are, say, lying very far away from this particular mean. So you can say they are the extreme values, or the highest and the lowest value of the given data, that are the extreme values. So by changing those extreme values, your data or the measure of dispersion, that should not vary. This is one thing. Another thing is that it should be capable of further algebraic treatment. So that means you could perform the you could use this measure of dispersion to calculate further. For example, you could calculate the correlation and regression, and moreover you could calculate the testing. You could perform this testing of hypothesis. So in this later on things and terms, or these topics, they require the use of this dispersion. So how many kind of methods of dispersion are present here with us? So let us see the methods of dispersion. They are mainly this five types. First is this range. Second is this interquartile range and quartile deviation. Third one is mean deviation. Fourth one is this standard deviation. And fifth one is the coefficient of variation. So these five quantities are present with us.